So if you wanted to calculate THD, or total harmonic distortion, as a percentage of the fundamental, here's how that works. Take a waveform like this, and you see how the waveform doesn't look like a nice, clean, sinusoidal waveform. That's because it's distorted from harmonics. So if we take just one electrical cycle of that waveform, that's the part that's highlighted in gray, we could take that and basically do a Fourier analysis, which is to take all of the sub-frequencies or the other frequencies that are associated with that waveform, break them down, and rebuild the waveform based on all those frequencies. This is what we would end up with. So you can see a fundamental part, a 60 hertz, and you can see a third harmonic, a fifth harmonic, a seventh harmonic, an 11th harmonic, a 13th harmonic. Those are typical harmonics that we might see on a power system. So if I wanted to calculate total harmonic distortion, the way I would do that is I would put this equation together with all those harmonic orders. I would square all of the harmonics, the third, the fifth, the seventh, the 11th, the 13th, and take the square root of that total and divide by the fundamental. In this case, since the fundamental is 100%, let's just use 100 amps as the number. And so we would have 20 amps of third harmonic, 12 amps of fifth, and so forth. As you can see, the higher order harmonics really don't become a big number when you square them. So the lower order harmonics are significant. And we end up with a number that's about 24% distortion. Now, let's see what happens if I change the fundamental current. So instead of having 100 amps, I have 50 amps. If I keep my harmonics the same, the third, fifth, seventh, 11th, 13th, the distortion value, the percent distortion, is now double what it was before. But if you think about it, the actual harmonic amps are the same. So don't get caught up in the fact that the harmonic percentages go up. Because at night, a lot of times you'll have a very low 60 hertz part, but the harmonic magnitudes or the actual amps of harmonics could be still the same or maybe about a little bit less, but the percentage looks like it's through the roof. So I always warn people, don't get caught up in the percentages. The actual amps or harmonic are what's doing the work and doing the problems that you see in the power system, the overheating and so forth. And by the way, when you have harmonic current distortion in amps, you produce harmonic voltage distortion in volts. So again, percentages can be misleading, but this is how you would calculate total harmonic distortion.